Grimm's Fairy Tales by the Brothers Grimm. Narrated by Richard Williams. Little Red Cap. Once upon a time there was a dear little girl who was loved by everyone who looked at her, but most of all by her grandmother, and there was nothing that she would not have given to the child. Once she gave her a little cap of red velvet, which suited her so well that she would never wear anything else, so she was always called Little Red Cap. One day her mother said to her, "Come, Little Red Cap, here is a little piece of cake and a bottle of wine. Take them to your grandmother. She is ill and weak, and they will do her good. Set out before it gets hot, and when you are going, walk nicely and quietly and do not run off the path, or you may fall and break the bottle, and then your grandmother will get nothing. And when you go to her room, don't forget to say, 'Good morning,' and don't peep into every corner before you do it." "I will take great care," said Little Red Cap to her mother, and gave her hand on it. The grandmother lived out in the wood, half a league from the village, and just as Little Red Cap entered the wood, a wolf met her. Red Cap did not know what a wicked creature he was, and was not at all afraid of him.
"Good day, Little Red Cap," said he.
"Thank you kindly, wolf."
"Whither away so early, Little Red Cap?"
"To my grandmother's."
"And what have you got in your apron?"
"Cake and wine. Yesterday was baking day, so poor sick grandmother is to have something good to make her stronger."
"Where does your grandmother live, Little Red Cap?"
"A good quarter of a league farther on in the wood. Her house stands under three large oak trees. The nut trees are just below. You must surely know it," replied Little Red Cap.
The wolf thought to himself,
"What a tender young creature. What a nice plump mouthful she will be. Better to eat than the old woman. I must act craftily so as to catch both." So he walked for a short time by the side of Little Red Cap, and then he said,
"See, Little Red Cap, how pretty the flowers are about here. Why do you not look around? I believe, too, that you do not hear how sweetly the little birds are singing. You walk gravely along as if you were going to school, while everything else out here in the wood is merry."
Little Red Cap raised her eyes, and when she saw the sunbeams dancing here and there through the trees, and pretty flowers growing everywhere, she thought, "Suppose I take Grandmother a fresh nosegay. That would please her too. It is so early in the day that I shall still get there in good time." And so she ran from the path into the wood to look for flowers. And whenever she had picked one, she fancied that she saw a still prettier one farther on, and ran after it, and so got deeper and deeper into the wood. Meanwhile, the wolf ran straight to the grandmother's house and knocked at the door.
"Who's there?"
"Little Red Cap," replied the wolf. "She is bringing cake and wine. Open the door."
"Lift the latch,"
called out the grandmother.
"I am too weak and cannot get up."
The wolf lifted the latch. The door sprang open, and without saying a word, he went straight to the grandmother's bed and devoured her. Then he put on her clothes, dressed himself in her cap, and laid himself in bed and drew the curtains. Little Red Cap, however, had been running about picking flowers, and when she had gathered so many that she could carry no more, she remembered her grandmother and set out on the way to her. She was surprised to find the cottage door standing open, and when she went into the room she had a strange feeling that she said to herself, "Oh dear, how uneasy I feel today. And at other times, I like being with Grandmother so much." She called out, "Good morning," but received no answer. So she went to the bed and drew back the curtains. There lay her grandmother, with her cap pulled far over her face and looking very strange.
"Oh, Grandmother," she said, "what big ears you have."
"The better to hear you with, my child," was the reply.
"But Grandmother, what big eyes you have," she said.
"The better to see you with, my dear."
"But, Grandmother, what large hands you have."
"The better to hug you with."
"Oh, but Grandmother, what a terrible big mouth you have."
"The better to eat you with."
And scarcely had the wolf said this, than with one bound he was out of bed and swallowed up Red Cap.
When the wolf had appeased his appetite, he lay down again in the bed, fell asleep, and began to snore very loud. The huntsman was just passing the house and thought to himself,
"We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description."